Back here, who will be Deputy Prime Minister is one of the unresolved issues of the coalition talks, according to Christopher Luxon. The contenders, veteran warhorse Winston Peters from New Zealand First, or ACT's David Seymour. Deputy Political Editor Mikey Sherman runs the political rule over them.
Christopher Luxon emerging from his home, no face-to-face negotiations today, just painstaking phone calls.
I've had to recharge my phone twice, so yeah, we've been on the phone a lot since early this morning.
Talks draining not just phones and the public will, but politicians as well. National's Nicola Willis and Chris Bishop flying home today.
I've just literally run out of clothes, so I've got to go home. This is Christopher Luxon's shirt. I borrowed it from him.
All I want is a good government for New Zealand. I want agreements signed so we can get on and govern.
There is just one gigantic problem.
Deputy Prime Minister, is that one of the big issues?
It's fair to say it is one of the ones, but as I said, those conversations stay private between myself and the leaders.
It's an almighty arm wrestle. Winston Peters versus David Seymour, neither backing down.
Yeah, not getting into any of that. Those conversations, as I've kept saying, and I know it's repetitive, but they are, you know, important that I respect the confidence of that room.
Signs of a deputy dust-up came earlier today. Nicola Willis officially bowing out.
Look, to be honest, I'm not in the race. David and Winston will do a great job.
But who, oh who, should it be? Winston Peters has greater experience entering Parliament almost 45 years ago, with two stints already as Deputy Prime Minister. But David Seymour has the bigger party, with 11 seats to New Zealand First's 8.
Why should the public believe that Winston Peters and David Seymour aren't holding the country to ransom?
I'm having good conversations with both those leaders. We're both, all three of us, are desperate to get it sorted, but we want to do it right, and so we will do it right.
David Seymour told One News he didn't have much to report today, but when we asked who would win in an arm wrestle between him and Winston Peters, he sent us this article suggesting he felt confident.
I think the problem that they've got now is that they've both said that they want it. And so whoever gets it, the other one looks like they're a loser.
Oh, look, I wouldn't use that colourful term, squabbling. This is all part of negotiations. And when the conjecture spills out in the public, it does excite people.
For now, it's simply a case of who blinks first as the leaders search for a solution.
Just offering up the idea of an arm wrestle.
Again, not necessary. What we've got to do is close this government, close these negotiations out.
Many hoping they close them out quickly. Mikey Sherman, One News.
Joining us now, political editor Jessica Much-Mackay. Jess, David Seymour's heading back to Wellington, we understand. What, if anything, can we read into that?
Well, the fact that all of the leaders and their negotiating teams are heading back here to Wellington, making their way back, shows that things are very close. David Seymour is set to land in a very short while at Wellington Airport. Christopher Luxon is due back later on tonight, or perhaps first thing tomorrow morning, and Winston Peters will be here a bit later tomorrow. So the focus is really now turning back here to the capital. I was told by a source that the plan for today was to try and lock in those ministerial portfolios, including that Deputy Prime Minister role, signal that, and then for all of the leaders to fly back here to Wellington tonight and announce a deal here in Wellington at the Beehive tomorrow. There are still a few hours left in the day for that to become a reality.
Is this a straight-up numbers fight? ACT is, after all, bringing more MPs to Parliament, or will Winston Peters experience trump that?
We just learnt today that this is a battle between just the two of them, with Winston Peters and David Seymour. Winston Peters, of course, has more experience. There's also the fact that if he becomes the Foreign Affairs Minister, that title of Deputy Prime Minister would give him mana when he's overseas. For David Seymour, he rightly points out that his party has more support, got more votes than New Zealand First, and the role should belong to him. Although he did spend a lot of time during the campaign saying it was more about policies rather than those ministerial positions. The Deputy Prime Minister role matters because when the Prime Minister is overseas, they're in charge. They're also in charge in this place on a Thursday. When the Prime Minister travels out to the regions and isn't here, it's a big prize and a big bauble for whoever secures it.
Tēnā koe, Jess. Thank you very much.